And now, our Father, we thank you. Thank you first for the gift of life, and that your grace and mercy has brought us one more time together. We thank you for the bishop of this congregation and for the under-shepherds and for the ministry of love and faith. We're grateful for the life and ministry of Alma Blackmon, our director and your daughter, whom you've given now 80 years. And it is your grace and mercy which has brought us together one more time. And as we prepare now to offer our songs of praise and thanksgiving, we honor you as the giver of all gifts, the gift of music, and we are but your instruments in your hands. And so, Lord, take us, use us, we ask. And we pray that both the musicians and the listeners shall be blessed, and that by faith we shall be transported to that time and place when together we shall sing the song of Moses and the Lamb. And it is to this end we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Friends, we all met at Oakwood College in Huntsville, Alabama. Oakwood College is a Seventh-day Adventist college in the Seventh-day Adventist North American education system. The person who has just conducted that response is Mervyn Warren. I was privileged to teach him piano and music theory, and he has his master's degree in composition and arranging from the University of Alabama in Tuscaloosa. Mervyn has been here before when Richard Smallwood used this auditorium to make his album. Mervyn wrote that introduction to Total Praise, and he conducted right here on the stage those strings that night. And there's another way that you all celebrate Mervyn every now and then. I've been out here at Christmas time and you sing that Joy to the World from that movie. Oh, tell the good story. Mervyn wrote that. See, he lives in Hollywood now and he does soundtracks for movies. So, you know, Sister Act 2 and The Wedding Planner, and what's the one that's out now?
A Walk to Remember.
A Walk to Remember. My child!
Found his promises are true. He's everything he said that he would be. Oh, the finest words I know could not begin to tell just how much Jesus really means to me. Fondest dreams. That the King of Glory would come to live within the heart of man.
Oh, I marvel just to know he really loves me when I think of who he is and who I am.
The Aeolians heard Mona sing this morning. They adopted her as an honorary Aeolian. So we're going to sing these pieces now with our new member, Mona.
Yeah.
beginning the light did shine. Jehovah, source of the light that shines. O'er the darkness, cloak of darkness, dispelled by the power of thy light. Gift of heaven, freely given to thine own, every blessing is revealed. We receive thee to live thee. There is life in thy peace.
My soul delights in thy works, O Lord. My own desire is to serve thee, Lord. Now embrace me.
Fruit of their doom. Mouth of the For he is King of kings, he is Lord of lords. Jesus Christ, the first and last, no man works like him. For he is King of kings, he is Lord of lords. Jesus Christ, the first and last, no man works like him. King Jesus rides a milk-white horse, no man works like him. The river of Jordan he did cross, no man works like him. For he is King of kings, Lord of lords. Oh, Jesus Christ, the first and last. Oh, King Jesus rides in the middle of the air. Oh, he calls the saints from everywhere.
Oh,
for some Negro spirituals. The first one is Oh Freedom, the second Give Me Jesus, and the third Way Over in Beulah Land. Now, I selected Oh Freedom to honor the work that Bishop Polk has done in the fight for our civil rights in the days of Martin Luther King. It says, Oh Freedom. Oh Freedom, oh Freedom over me, and before I'd be a slave, I'd be buried in my grave and go home to my God and be free. Amen. Now we have sung that under a lot of different circumstances. In fact, our first album, which was an LP, you can't get it anymore, and I'm so sorry, is entitled Oh Freedom. It's just a complete album of Negro spirituals arranged by Hall Johnson. The most peculiar circumstances under which we sang it was in the city of Pulaski, Tennessee. Now, I don't know if that means anything to you, but there was a college there that used to send for us every year to come and sing spirituals during Black History Month, and it was a college of white leadership. And we went every year, you know, we went on the bus. One year, they got very ritzy and sent a limo for me, divided me from my students. And as we, and I mean, I had a liveried chauffeur, and I'm in this limo by myself. And we pass a white building, a white brick building on the corner, which said Singer Sewing Machine. And the chauffeur said, you see that white building there, that Singer building? I said, yes. He said, that's where the Ku Klux Klan was founded. I said, what? He said, I tell you, for a moment, I didn't feel very comfortable. I said, why did they separate me from my students? Lord, I'm out here on my own with this chauffeur whom I don't know. So we got over there and we were doing the concert, and I, you know, I'm sort of nervy. So I turned around when I announced this one. I said, I learned a fact about Pulaski, Tennessee today. And the audience laughed. The audience was mainly white, so I imagine they knew what I was going to say. I said, we're going to sing now, Oh Freedom, we have a message for you in this song, if there happen to be any members of the Klan here. Well, the students are on the bus going back, and I didn't know whether any members of the Klan were there either. You've heard how people get in a limo and they say, home, James, you know that. I said to the man, drive me quickly from the city.
Oh,
Very well-known Aeolians is named Wintley Phipps. And he's going to sing next. You haven't seen him in the choir where he would have been, but he told me he had a concert scheduled at Andrews University in Michigan last night. Then he called me this morning and he let me know that he had caught a bug somewhere and had to cancel that concert, but he booked himself a flight here, because he didn't want to disappoint us. Now, I think this will be Wendy's third performance in this church. He came here and he did the cantata Savior, which he recorded with Larnell Harris. And he was in your performance. And then he came back because you had him to have his U.S. Dream Academy for Children of Prisoners, that fundraiser here. And so you see, loving you and being gracious and thankful to you and loving me, he could not disappoint us. I present to you now Wintley Phipps, who's going to sing for us Over a Cold. Where are you, baby?
one of the great revelations of Scripture is that God can sing. The book of Zephaniah, it talks about God rejoicing over us with singing. Now, there are some things about God singing that's very different than our singing. For one, he doesn't have to rehearse. You don't need sheet music. It's all improv. And then he expresses his deepest emotions in song. So imagine when we get to glory, we'll be making up excuses just to go by the throne room. Just to hear God singing. This song is a song that describes God singing, dreaming about making man, creating Adam, Adam closing his eyes, then opening them again and realizing that he's gazing on the features of divinity, and Adam stands there stunned because God begins to sing to him. And he says in his song to Adam and to us, "My heart belongs to you." Listen to the message of this song.
Who will hear the music that I hear? Who will hear the sound that fills the air? Who will see a radiant beam of light dancing for a sun that warms a morning sky? Who will know the beauty of my earth, since the joy and wonder of its birth? Who will see the glory of the world that I have made? And who will walk beside me in the garden in the coolness of the day? Creation's glorious song that comes from my heart expresses strains of love, but only in part. I long to hear the words, the words that are true. Someone to say, "My heart belongs to you." And who will feel the summer wind that moves across the water as it flows? Who will enjoy the orchestrated mystery that soars within my soul? Who will hear the glory of the music that I hear? I will create man to be in my own image, form him from the dust of earth, and breathe into him my own breath of life. Hear you speak to me.
the joy when you're here with me. The message of my song will always be true. Mi corazón, my heart belongs to you. You will enjoy the orchestrated mystery that soars within my soul. And we can feel the summer wind that moves across the water as it flows. This wondrous paradise and all that you see could never match the joy when you're here with me. Always look for songs that help us to understand what God has done for us. And I came across such a song. It's a very simple song, but it is an awesome song. It's really a true story. You see, during World War II, one night an American troop ship was torpedoed. And as the ship was sinking, four United States chaplains were on deck handing out life jackets until they realized they had run out of life jackets. It's a true story. And these four United States chaplains took off their own life jackets and handed it to four young sailors who needed it. And they perished arm in arm as the ship went down. This song means a lot to me because it reminds me of what Jesus did for us. You see, he took off his life jacket, handed it to you. And you, so that we could live. So as you listen to the words of this true story, see yourself receiving from the hands of someone giving their life for you a life jacket. Listen to the message. Through dark of night, a ship sailed on the water. 900 men at war, so far from home. The icy sea from Newfoundland to Greenland, a battlefield upon the ocean foam. The deadly force of enemy torpedoes then broke the eerie silence of the night, and chaos reigned as blood revealed a horror. Some men would live, but some would surely die. Four chaplains, men of different faiths, men of honor, true and brave, gave life-preserving jackets to their men. And when there were no more to give, they willed that four more men might live, as willingly they gave their all. Quietly they walked among the wounded, without regard for color, race, or creed, speaking words of hope to those despairing, hurrying to meet each human need. Their legacy will live throughout the ages. Two Protestants, one Catholic, and a Jew, who gave their all while knowing death awaited. True holy men who did what God would do. Four chaplains, men of different faiths, men of honor, true and brave, gave life-preserving jackets to their men. And when there were no more to give, they willed that four more men might live, as willingly they gave their all. In majesty they rode that sea of glory, giving all that any man can give, not knowing that the world would hear their story of how they died that other men might live. Four chaplains with uncommon faith, born to serve and born to save, stood arm in arm upon that sinking ship, dying with a prayer upon their lips.
One of our accompanists, Brian Jones, who accompanied Margie a little while ago, played his version of the Lord's Prayer yesterday, and I was worn out listening to it. So I thought you all might like to hear it. You know, Richard Smallwood's played his Lord's Prayer on this piano, and then he and Clarice sat there together and played it one night. She imitated everything he did. If he'd go dee dee dee, she'd do it up an octave higher. And of course, he was astounded. Listen to Brian Jones in the Lord's Prayer. You will be tired too.
Thank you.
Can you imagine the kind of fun we had in school? I just don't understand it, but the Lord just seems to send the most talented students in the country to Oakwood College. Everybody can sing. We're going to close now with our final group. It will consist of these three songs: For God So Loved the World, I Heard the Voice of Jesus Say, and Lord, What Is Man? Before we sing, Lord, What Is Man, I want to ask the bishop to come up here so we can make it a personal serenade for him. Some of you may not know, but I operate a cancer prayer circle because I've had cancer twice, and the Lord has healed me both times, and I'm very grateful. Yeah. And when the bishop learned about it, he invited me to come here and tell about it at one of the morning services. And of course, these services are telecast, and so people saw it lots of places. And then people began to call the cathedral, and some people just found me through information. Some found it because you introduced Brenda that day, and you said, Channel 11, Brenda Wood. And so people from California called Channel 11 to find Brenda Wood, to find her mother. And they were saying things like, I need the faith of that woman. I have cancer. Some people called me that didn't have cancer, just wanted me to pray for them. At any rate, out of this very telecast from this pulpit, this cancer prayer circle of mine was born. So I feel sort of like I'm at home today. I have an attachment with this church. At that time, we had no idea that the bishop would be stricken with cancer. But he was. And I put him in that prayer circle. And let me tell you, it's based on James 5:16 that says, pray for one another that ye may be healed. I don't think there is another ministry like mine where all the sick people are praying for each other. They all have each other's names all over the country in Bermuda and London, praying for each other. In the time since I testified here, I have ministered to 165 patients. 40 have died. But 120 some are still battling with the disease. Some have been declared in remission, but I don't stop my ministry to them just because that has happened, because I know from my own experience that cancer is a 5-year disease. They watch you for 5 years before they say that you're well. So, because of the shared experience that the bishop and I have had, because I had the opportunity to minister to him, and I used to feel so weak to call him and say, may I pray with you? You know, for me to be offering a prayer for him seemed to be out of balance, but I did it anyway. And one night I walked in here, because the present Aeolians of Oakwood College were doing a concert here, and I walked up behind him and put my arms around him. He turned around to see who this was, who had the nerve. And as soon as he saw my face, he said, Alma, my PSA count has gone down from 236 to 0.1. And Clarice told me to come up here and introduce the Aeolians, but I said, before I do that, I said to the audience, I'd like to make a personal announcement. And I announced the bishop's healing, and this auditorium erupted. People were on their feet, and I was standing on the stage, glory to God. Come up here, we want to personally serenade you. Lord, what is man?
Thank you. strikes his lightning down. Who shakes the worlds above? And mountains tremble at his frown. How wondrous is his love.
Come on and help me thank these folk tonight for a beautiful presentation. And here comes Sister Clarice to give you just a little remembrance. By the way, you know, I've tried every way to get into this group. I tried to sound low this morning, and I thought when she said, we're going to have an honorary member to come, I started to get up and walk up here, and whatever it needs, I'll shave my head. I mean, whatever you want me to do, just let me know. But this is just the finest group I ever saw, and I just love you. I really do love you. But if you, Alma, would give us permission, and if you permit this, we will offer this video on television, and every dime that we make of it will go to your cancer research group. We'll go to your prayer group. Would you let us do that? If you let us do that, would you let us do that?
Yes.
All right, then we'll get the video out, and a lot of these folks are going to buy it, and whatever comes in from that, every penny that comes in, will go to your prayer group that you so graciously let me be a part of, and we're going to start it tonight with $1,000. So it's going to be something really great, isn't it? Yes. Yes. I'm so excited about doing this. This is one of the best things I've been a part of in a long, long time. And if you just ever decide you want to do another reunion here, please, please, Think of us. Will you do that? Think of us. Okay. It will be done. All right. I'm so grateful for this day. It's been a great day. You're going to give tonight. Father, I thank you for the contributions that will come from your people, that our needs are met. Your kingdom will come. We thank you for tonight. In Jesus' name, God bless you as you give tonight.
It's because of what I've done. It's because I said His grace has set me free. His blood is flowing through my veins. I'm adopted by the King. It's because of who.
Oh. Because of who I am.
It's because of who I am.
Hallelujah!
Thank you.